สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Hot Thai Kitchen. And today I've got another video in my Ingredient 101 series. And today we're gonna tackle the monster of a topic that is soy sauce. When you go to an Asian grocery store, sometimes it can be overwhelming because like half of an entire aisle is just covered in soy sauce and you just don't know which one to pick, right? So hopefully this video will answer some of your questions and help you with that. And by the way, if you are interested in learning more about other Thai ingredients, I have a whole list of other videos. I will link to them in the description below. But first, two caveats. So soy sauce is a huge topic. So I have to say that there is no time for me to go into every detail about every kind of soy sauce. So I'm gonna do my best to give you what I think is what you will need most of the time. Number two is, this being a Thai cooking show, I'm gonna focus a little bit more on the Thai soy sauce and the differences between them. So we'll touch on other countries as well, but not in super detail. All right, that is it. Let's get started. So first, what is soy sauce? At the very basic level, soy sauce is made from four main ingredients. It's soybeans, wheat, salt, and water, and it's all fermented together using a special mold with a special name called koji. And so each manufacturer will have different recipe, different processes, so that's why you end up with so many different variations. Let's talk three main categories of soy sauce. Regular, dark, and sweet. Now, there's just main categories, and within these, it varies from country to country, and there's like other subcategories, but let's just keep it to a manageable size here. So regular soy sauce are all the different bottles that will only say soy sauce on it. Okay, when a recipe calls for soy sauce, the regular soy sauce is what you need it for, and you use regular soy sauce when the main purpose is to get saltiness. That sounds obvious, but it's important for me to bring that up because when we talk about dark and sweet, you realize that you don't always want saltiness when you use soy sauce, okay? So here are all the different ones that I have from different countries. The one that I always use in my recipe is a Thai soy sauce. That's this one. This is Healthy Boy brand. It's sort of like a national brand that most households will use. This is important. The one that I'm using here is a mushroom soy sauce. And this is the one exception where if we're talking Thai soy sauce, there are two types of regular soy sauce, the mushroom one and the non-mushroom one. They're just slightly different flavors. They are completely interchangeable in all recipes. People just choose what they prefer in terms of flavor. So if you can't find the mushroom soy sauce, the other regular soy sauce one, the label will be yellow, will work just as well. You cannot substitute non-Thai mushroom soy sauce for this, okay? This is why this is an exception. Chinese people also make a mushroom soy sauce. It is not the same, it's very different. Usually it's very dark. So just know that if you just want regular soy sauce, look for a bottle that just says soy sauce, except for the Thai one where you're allowed to do mushroom soy sauce. See, I told you this was complicated. The next category is dark soy sauce. So dark soy sauce is what you want to use when the main purpose that you want out of them is a dark, rich color, like in my pad see ew recipe or something like that. It is not very salty at all, so this is not what you will add if you want things to be salty. Now, in Thailand, in Thai cuisine, we refer to our dark soy sauce as black soy sauce. That's how I always refer to them. There are a couple of brands that you can find on the market. This Dragonfly brand is what I usually, is what I grew up with, so it's what I usually use at home. It's becoming a little harder to find now, so you might find the Healthy Boy brand. They both work, but I have to warn you that the Healthy Boy is a lot darker. So when I made the switch, I added Healthy Boy and it was like, oh my God, it's so dark. So a little bit of all of this stuff goes a long way. So you don't want to add a lot or it starts tasting a bit weird. The Chinese dark soy sauce is a good substitute for when I call for black soy sauce. It'll also make your stuff really dark, but it's also a lot saltier. So if you want to substitute, you want to reduce the amount of regular soy sauce or fish sauce that I call for. Finally, sweet soy sauce. Now, not every cuisine uses sweet soy sauce. In Thailand, we use a little bit, only in dipping sauces usually, but not in regular cooking that I've ever seen. But in Indonesian and Malaysian cuisine, this is like one of the main things that live in their pantry. So I only have one bottle to show. It's the only one that I can find, and it is an Indonesian one. It's really good. It's almost like a combination of molasses and soy sauce. A little bit salty, but really thick and syrupy and sweet. It's really delicious. So it's good in like fried rice, fried noodles, whatever. Not a big deal if you can't find it. You're not gonna come across it a lot unless you're cooking Indonesian or Malaysian food. Now let's talk alternative soy-based sauces. So these are not labeled as soy sauce, but they essentially are soy sauce. They're made from fermented soybeans, they're salty and all that stuff, but the flavor profile is different from your regular soy sauce. So I'll show you some examples. You've seen me use all the time Golden Mountain sauce. The generic term for Golden Mountain sauce is actually seasoning sauce. In Thai, it's called sauce bunglot, which literally means seasoning sauce, which is the least informative label ever, because aren't they all seasoning sauces? But Golden Mountain is sort of like a brand, a household name brand. It's sort of like Kleenex. Everybody sort of refers to it as Golden Mountain, but there are other brands. So like Healthy Boy also makes a seasoning sauce. It tastes kind of like soy sauce. I find the color and flavor is a little more intense, a little richer. So I don't tend to use it as a main seasoning because it can be a little overpowering. You can really taste it. A similar thing is Maggi. Now Maggi isn't actually of Asian origin. I think it's originated in Switzerland or something. It has a similar-ish flavor to Golden Mountain. I would say it is a good substitute. And then there's also Liquid Amino, which you might have seen. So this is a gluten-free soy-based seasoning. So it's like a gluten-free soy sauce. But in my experience, I think it tastes very much like Maggi, but Maggi is not gluten-free, so this is a good option for you. I love that it comes in like a spray bottle, because then if you're like trying to season like your eggs or your rice, whatever, it's evenly distributed. So that's an option for you. There's also something called tamari, which I don't have to show, but tamari is also a gluten-free soy sauce. It's not always gluten-free. It's a Japanese version of a soy sauce that's made using little or no wheat. Most of the ones that you find in North America are going to be gluten-free. And so if you're celiac or you can't eat gluten, that tamari would be what you would use as a substitute for all of the regular soy sauces. Let's quickly talk things that are called low sodium soy sauce and light soy sauce. So low sodium soy sauce is basically regular soy sauce that just has less salt in it. That's not something a recipe would generally call for. It's something you would want to use if you're concerned about your salt intake. You just use the same amount, and the idea is you get less salt but the same oomph of flavor. That's the idea. Light soy sauce, on the other hand, is different. So from my experience, when a soy sauce is labeled light soy sauce, what they really mean is regular soy sauce. But they just say light because they also sell a dark soy sauce, and the company just wants to differentiate the difference between the two. Now, I don't know that that's a fact for all brands, but the brands that I've seen at the grocery store, usually the light is just a regular equivalent. And by the way, for our Patreon members who have access to the show after the show, today I'm going to share with you some unconventional ways I like to use soy sauce, and also what is Adam's favorite soy sauce. Each country has its own soy sauce, and they're all different. So I've got a few to show here. There's a Thai one, Japanese, this is Korean, Chinese, and Filipino. Which one are you gonna buy? You're probably not gonna be crazy like me and own all five of these. So which one should you have? So the most hardcore answer is that whatever cuisine you are cooking, that's the soy sauce that you should be using. If you're cooking Thai food, you wanna use Thai soy sauce. You're cooking Chinese food, you wanna use Chinese soy sauce, because that's how you get the most authentic flavor. But if you cook a little bit of everything, you don't wanna end up owning all of these, right? That just take up space in your fridge. So my suggestion would be, just think about the two that you cook the most and just have those. If it's Japanese and Thai, then have these two. If it's Chinese and Japanese, then have these two. But if you cook a little bit of everything and you want like the one all-purpose soy sauce that would work across cuisines, This breaks my heart because I would say Thai soy sauce, but I think Japanese soy sauce is probably going to be the more versatile one in terms of its similarity to other soy sauces. Now, is it going to ruin the dish if you use a Japanese soy sauce in Thai cooking and you kind of cross-pollinate these? No, it's absolutely not going to ruin the dish. It's going to taste a little different, but it'll be fine. The only one that I think is pretty different is the Filipino one is a lot darker, I find. So I wouldn't use this one as your like basic soy sauce for everything. That might just be the one caveat. And also the reason why I say Japanese soy sauce as your all-purpose is when you do cook Japanese food is very subtle in flavor. So the flavor of soy sauce really shows through. So that I think would be the one cuisine you want to use the appropriate soy sauce for. And how do you store soy sauce? Storage is a question that I get a lot. So if you have room in the fridge, put it in the fridge. It's not gonna go bad outside. I mean, there's so much salt in here, it's not going to spoil on you, but it will maintain its flavor best in the fridge. Having said that, if you go to Thailand, all Thai people keep their soy sauce at room temperature, but we go through it a lot, right? So, but if you're not cooking a lot of Asian food, this bottle's gonna last you 2 years. You don't wanna be leaving that on the counter. And that is it. I hope you found that useful. If you have more questions, definitely feel free to reach out to me on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. And if you have any soy sauce tidbits to share, share it with us in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed to the show, make sure you do so you don't miss an episode. And click the bell icon as well, because that will send you a notification when I post a new video. And if you want to join our Patreon club, you can check out all the information. I'll put the link in the description below as well. And I will see you next time. Sawasdee ka.